After we published our video explaining how you can turn your Mac into a PC, particularly if you're heading into finance, got a lot of follow-up questions about my particular configuration and how I went through this, particularly for Parallels and Shadow PC. And today I'm going to walk through the Parallel setup and what I put together for that, and then I'll follow up with a second video explaining how I set up Shadow. So to begin with here, I'm going to go into my settings, and I go down to Keyboard, and then in Keyboard, I'm going to go to Keyboard Shortcuts here. And the first thing we need to do is just untoggle a few things in our basic Mac keyboard shortcut settings. So I go into Mission Control, and I unclick Mission Control itself and then the application window. So this is Control Up Arrow and Control Down Arrow, which you use a lot in Excel, particularly when you're over in Parallels. And I don't like for these to conflict. If you use these shortcuts a lot, I would just remap them while you're setting things up to work over in Parallels. It's really my least bad option. There is a program called Better Touch Tool that is really, really helpful, that can really just undo shortcuts or retoggle shortcuts. I actually use it in Mac natively. You don't need it for what we're talking about here. But if you want to remap and you don't want to do it through this interface with the Mac OS native interface, you can use Better Touch Tool. And I've personally found that one really helpful. But for now, I'm going to unclick Mission Control and unclick Application Windows. And then I'm going to toggle through these. So I also unclick these two items because these are keystrokes I use a lot in Excel. And again, I don't want them to conflict. Really, everything else, though, almost without exception, is the same as it was by default. So we're good there. And then moving into the modifier keys, as we'll talk about in a second, you can adjust these. But I wouldn't, unless you really, really care about moving fast in Excel. And even for me, who cares? Someone who cares a lot, I only toggle this occasionally, and I'll show you why. So we're going to keep this with the default settings, but really the first thing is just unclicking some of those items so we don't have conflicts between Mac and Parallels. So I'll close that out, and then from there, I'm going to move over to my Parallel settings. So I set up Parallels, I have Excel set up, everything's running, and I'm going to go here to my Parallels interface. I'm going to go to Preferences, and the thing to understand here is that by default, you have all these application shortcuts that are set up. I unclick all of those because, again, I don't want things to conflict. What they're trying to do is make this easier for Mac users who are accustomed to certain shortcuts, and I just don't need this, so I get rid of it. From there, I honestly can't remember which item here is toggled by default. I do always here, and it seems to me like there should be never. Like, you don't want the two systems interacting when you're working over in Parallels, but for some reason, always is what you have to click, and that's what I click. Here, I don't have anything that I toggled. If this is toggled, I would untoggle it. Yeah, no, I wouldn't worry about it. I mean, you could, this actually could be useful. The secondary click key is nice, but I don't usually do that. So then I'm going to skip over what my actual setting is and go into what this looks like. You have these default mode settings, and you have one for Mac OS, should have one for Windows, and you have all these keyboard shortcuts. And again, what's happening here is Parallels is trying to set this up to make it easier for Mac users. But for someone who's trying to learn to use a PC, which is what we're really aiming to do here, you don't want these. And so I'm going to leave these on. But as you'll see, I basically get rid of all of this when I move into Parallels. But for now, just to demonstrate something, I need to keep this on. And I'm going to close this out as if this were my settings. And I'm going to swipe over into Parallels. And the thing to understand is that when you get to Parallels, by default, the Option key is your Alt key, and the Command key is your Windows key. And what you need to do is flip those two so that you can get everything to work here. And what you can do, you can do this outside of Parallels itself. Since we're already in Parallels, I'm going to hit the keys here. So it's, I can never remember. It looks like it's Control and Option. If you click Control and Option to move your cursor up, it'll bring down this little bar, which is that same set of keyboard settings. Click Customize. And then what I did was I created a separate profile here, which you could pick any of these existing profiles. You can see I've got a bunch, and just untoggle everything. And what I ultimately settled on was I want my Command key to be Alt. I want my Option key to be Windows. Close it out. And if I go back into Excel now, if I hit my Command key, I get my Alt menu. If I hit my Option key, I get my Windows menu, and everything's good to go. Now, that will work for 95% of people, particularly someone who's just getting up the curve, who's not, admittedly like me, a little neurotic about the speed of this. And The thing to understand is that when you work in Excel in an actual PC, there's a different dynamic with the Alt key than what you're seeing here. So I'm just going to demonstrate this. I'm going to hit Alt, and there's essentially a half a second or quarter second delay here. So if I go Alt, it takes at least a half second for the menu to toggle here. And so, for example, if I'm working in Excel, if I do like Alt IW to insert worksheet, Alt IW, it just jams up. It doesn't actually work. Whereas if I do Alt, pause, I, then W, it's going to create a new worksheet. And what you can do to remedy this is flip the keys. So if I go back over to the Mac interface, if you really want to, this is the thing I probably wouldn't recommend doing unless you're doing a ton of work in Excel and you really care about the speed. What you can do is flip the modifier keys here. So we'll go to Option and flip it to Command. We'll go to Command and flip it to Option. And then we're going to go back over here, and then we have to go up to the menu again to reset our keyboard because now everything's flipped. And what you have to do is go into this, and there we go. Jeanette, I just made a profile with no settings. So now I have no remapping, and this actually works. So if I do Alt here, it's going to come up really fast. And if I do Alt W, just like I would in a PC, it works and there's no delay, and so I can hit my keyboard shortcuts just like I would on a PC. So there's a little bit of a delay. This personally drives me a little bonkers sometimes. But if you, again, if you're not really focused on the absolute maximum speed, it just doesn't really make that big of a difference. The other thing to note is that when you're in here, if you want to toggle the different sheets, just worth noting, you can do Control Shift Page Down. It works just like in a PC. And really, at this point, all of the shortcuts should work just like a PC. And if you're learning the Excel shortcuts for, if you're learning it in preparation for investment banking, for private equity, for credit, or whatever the case may be, you really want to make sure that you're internalizing these shortcuts. So, if you go to the ribbon, it's Alt and then H, and you really know how all this works, because if you go over to Excel for Mac, it just doesn't work the same way. There's no Alt key. There are some things that can help you get kind of halfway there, but they're just not great. And so the punchline here is when you're setting up your Excel in Parallels, what I would generally recommend is going back over here for one sec, is flipping this back to the normal. Oh, I hit the wrong one. So Control, Option, Command, done. And back over here. I would recommend that same setup I had before. And then again, the really the core setting you want to have in place is with the remapping of Command to Alt and Option to Windows, and then everything works. The one last thing to mention here that I've started using over the last year or two is a remapping tool. At points in time, sometimes I want to remap keys. And previously I'd use sharp keys, which is helpful. But there's a native Microsoft tool here that we can use called Power Toys. And if you go into Power Toys, which you can just Google Power Toys, go to the Microsoft Store and download it, in Power Toys, in their free version, you have a keyboard manager that allows you to go toggle different keyboard settings if you want to play around with keyboard remapping, and you don't have to reset your computer. So if you ever did want to remap keys in any way, I'd highly recommend checking this. Sharp keys is great, but it requires you to restart the computer every time you change something. This just remaps everything natively, and it's just a lot easier to use, at least in my experience. And so hopefully this gives a little bit more clarity about how to set up your Mac to work like a PC, particularly in Parallels, and particularly when you're using Excel.